Visual timelines are a great way to quickly convey key milestones, and adding animation takes them to the next level. Hey everyone, I'm Jennifer Sharkey, presentation and public speaking consultant. In this video, I will demonstrate how I create and animate a visual timeline. Let's get started. First, as a time-saving strategy, I identify the exact information I want to include on the slide. Visual timelines should not be text heavy, so it's really important to be succinct and to the point. In this example, I include the month and milestone because the timeline also includes icons. I'll list what icon I want for each milestone. Now, onto the first part of the creation process, making the timeline. Insert a slide with the layout title only. Change the default font in the Design tab to Century Gothic. In the View tab, show the guides and grid lines to help align the objects. First, add the teardrop shape. Rotate it so that it points downward. Using the small yellow sizing handle, drag down to extend the point. Then add a circle. Change the color to white and no outline, and place it over the teardrop. Last, add the icon, resize it to fit the circle, and change the color to a medium gray. Then group these elements together. Next, add another circle. In the Shape Format tab, lock the aspect ratio and change the size to 0.25. Align the elements using Align Center in the Shape Format tab. Then group all of these elements together. Duplicate this group four more times. Drag the right and left teardrop to each end of the slide, and select all of the groups and evenly distribute horizontally from the Shape Format tab. Change each icon by selecting the Change Graphic button in the Graphic Format tab and choosing From Icons. Now change the shape fill of the teardrop and corresponding circle. I like downloading color palettes from the website Coolers. I added the palette image to the slide and then used the eyedropper option to select the color. To do this, select the teardrop and the small circle. Click the drop-down arrow in the Shape Fill button on the Shape Format tab. Click More Colors and click the eyedropper icon. Then click the color in the color palette image and repeat for the rest of the elements. Next, draw a line from the left of the slide to about 1.5 inches. Holding down the Shift key helps keep the line straight. Then change the color to a medium gray. Set the line weight to 6 points. Duplicate the line using Command D or Control D in Windows. Make the line longer to about 2 or 2.5 inches. Select the second line and duplicate 4 more times. Select all of the lines, then align them using the line middle in the Shape Format tab, and using the arrow keys to align with the small circles. Now add the text box for the month and add the text. Change the font size to 32, add the text box for the milestone, and change the font size to 24, center the text, and resize the box as needed. Then duplicate both text boxes and move under the second teardrop. Duplicate these 3 more times. Change the text for each month and milestone. Okay, once you have all of the base elements of the timeline, the second part of the process is to actually apply the animation. If you're getting value from this video, make sure you like and subscribe. First, select all of the teardrop groups and select Ungroup from the Shape Format tab, or you can right-click and ungroup. Selecting the first line, click the Animations tab and choose Wipe. Choose From Left in the Effects option button and increase the duration to 1 second. Select the small group and choose the Appear Animation and change the start to After Previous. Then select the first teardrop group and choose the wipe animation and change the direction from top in the effects option button. Change the start to after previous. Select the first text boxes and choose the wipe animation and change the start to with previous. Then select the first line and double click the animation painter. Then click each line to apply the same animation. Click the animation painter button again to deactivate it. Now use the animation painter for all of the other elements. Now display the animation pane and drag and drop the animations into the correct order. By going into presentation mode, you can see what the entire animation will look like. If you have a longer timeline, here's a good strategy to use. Duplicate the slide and add the push transition to that slide. Remove the animation from the first line for a smoother transition. Here is what it looks like. The link to download the free template is in the description below. Continue watching for more slide design and animation tips and tricks.